as mountains. Where they came from, they still have Koti, their own tribes people who know them very, very well. And their language are similar. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So let us talk about the Igbos, which is means to Lord. Igbo, which is Lord. Hebele, which is Lamb. Hebele. Then Ebel, Ram. Abu, Song. Ibri means the one passed over. This is the same like this one. One passed over. A wanderer. A name usually associated with him. Avlaban. Hello? The name which is usually associated with him. Avram. Now we shall talk about Avram in the next part two. I'll talk about this. I'll explain to you what it is. Now maybe I can talk about it as we have found it. But Avram, this is Abram. Abram is in Kikaonde, Kabula Vana. Habula Vana. Ye who has no children. Ye who has no children. That's what it means, Habula Vana. When God changed his name to Abraham, when God changed his name to Abraham, it was now Kavula Vana. Kavula Vana. Avana Vafula. Now children are more. Kavula Vana. That's how it is. Now, why? How could this? And it means the same. There's no any other meaning apart from Yehudi, the Kaonde meaning, which is the true meaning of these words. No any other can explain it like the Kaondes, because the Kaondes are a true tribe of Israel. And Kavula Vana, and in Bemba it's the same. Kavula Vana. Or Kabulavana. Wabulavana. The exiled Jews, the Igbos. Now, when you see that the Igbos started changing their names, the change of the names came as a result of trying to disguise yourself. Are you getting me? You're trying to disguise yourself because they were the ones to be sold, they were the ones to be slaves. They were the ones to be sacrificed. They were the ones to be killed. They were the ones to have all the calamity. So you cannot maintain the name, your original name. And actually, when you say the name is Hebrew. Is it Hebrew? Hebrew. Hebrew is an English name. It's not a Bantu. It's not the Israelite type of a name. It's not named like that. Are you getting me? It's supposed, we don't have Hebrew. Hebrew is English. So, but then this is not, would have not been the same way as well. Because this is branding. Are you getting me? This is branding. You brand yourself so that you can be not, you cannot be known. So, and what does Hebrew mean? It means crossing. Crossing, you cross over. When you cross, Habuka, in Kaonde, Hebele. That's what it is. So the British called them originally, referred to them as Ifite, which is Ivrit, In Anambra, Igbo areas, it is called Ivrit. They are called Ivrit. But this is the they are called Hebrews. Are you getting me? So, Dr. Johnny Johnson, they are Hebrews. They are Igbos. They are Israelites. They are our people. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
Then the Hebrew original name Habiru. If you see, Habiru, which means Abuka, Abula, Habiru. In a Kaonde, Abula or Abula or Abula or Abuka, it's also sounds the same. Across the river. This is the same meaning with the pure language of God. When you crossed over, his name was called the Hebrews, when Abraham crossed over. Why Africans do not call themselves Hebrews? Because of the wrong pronunciation. The term Hebrew is the English translation of the term Abiru, Abila, Abelu, Abula, Abuka, Abula, meaning cross. In Hebrew, the consonant like L and R can be exchanged, can exchange to K or vice versa. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
I mentioned this about as we are starting. This denoted the crossing from the human culture to the scriptural culture of Yahweh or Jehovah. You've got to come from the tradition of being a human being, of your human customs, our human way of doing things. You go to the tradition of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You got the tradition of God. So when we talk about the great awakening, we are awakening you people from being dead. Like it is written that I was placed in the valley full of dry bone. People have been dead for many years. So we are awakening you to the righteousness of God. Awakening you from your deadly traditions. When you talk about the tradition of the Kaondes, most of all the traditions of the Kaondes are all Old Testament. We just take the Old Testament and you start reading the through the Old Testament, that is their tradition. Most of the Bantu speaking, our tradition is all Old Testament. We don't need to be taught, but we need, yes, are we living that? Or we just practice it now? Now that's a custom. It has remained as a custom because we have embraced the white man's, the Western, we have embraced the Western culture. We look at the Western, ours is looked at as demonic, eh? It's all demonic. But we look at the other West, the Western is nearer God. But we didn't even know that it is the Bible. The Bible is a book for the Bantu people. Talks about our God. And our Christ came to us.
Yes.
He didn't come to the old world.
Yes, sir.
He came to us. When we became foolish and we rejected him, he gave power to whosoever could accept him. And then he had to remove the laws and he put only grace because they were Gentiles. So you Gentiles can be saved by grace. So that's how they are saved by grace. And then us, when we were now getting converted as Christians, and even our conversion as Christians, the white people, the slave masters, when they came to our people, they said that, put all your books aside. Put all your books aside and give us. We confiscate them. Use this book. Use this book, this put aside, and use this. If you don't, even as old as you are, who have remained, we are taking you, you die on the ship. So choose to convert to Christianity or you remain as people of the book or the Bible as a Hebrew. Then our people converted. So to convert to Christianity, it came by force. It is not that for Bantus that we just got it like that. And our enemies used the same book, our own book. He used our weakness in order to enslave us and in order to steal from us. He came with it. They said that, okay, we have taken their people as slaves. We have taken their people as slaves. Having taken their people as slaves, now their land is very rich. What can we do? Then one man in America, in Americas, that's the way they call him, in Americas, one man said that, you know one thing, With these guys, the black, the Negroes, when they start eating well, they start living well, they build up. We build up. They are very strong people. I am scared at my farm. Sometimes, maybe one day they will rebel against me. This is historically proven and written. So they might come against me. So what can I do? They might say, no. You know, these people are Israelites. They are Hebrews. So as Hebrews, they like God. They have got the fear of God and they are always attached to God. Anything they hear about God, they will kneel. They will kneel, they will bow. When you just mention God, they will bow. Even today, governments are using the Bible. They hide behind the Bible because they know the weakness of the Africans. I'm not talking about Zambians. I'm not talking about the Zambian governments or whatever. I'm talking about African governments, which could include Zambia maybe. So they hide behind the Bible. They will bring the Bible to you because they know naturally it is in our DNA. Whenever you mention the Bible, you say, the Lord Jesus is saying this. You quote two scriptures. Even if you are a bad person, you are bringing bad thing, policies and whatever, we shall be quiet, we shall say we deceive. Even the bad we deceive. Why? Because of what you have mentioned. We don't want to be in bad faith, bad relations with the one you have mentioned. So that's how this man advised his friend that for me, I have introduced the word of God to them and they are working hard. I tell them pray in the morning. I tell them have the word. They are having that and they are enjoying it so much and no rebellion. No rebellion and they are working for me. Me, I know there's no God. Me, I know there's no word, but they are working for me. Things are working out. Then when it worked out, then that became adopted in America and wherever the blacks were taken. And then they said, we're going back to Africa because Africa is more richer than our place. All the resources we need to build our countries are in Africa. So we are going there. So if you are going there, the first thing you must go with is the Bible. Go with the Bible because by nature, those people are Hebrews. The people, their old name is people of the book. That's what is written in the Quran. They are called people of the book. So you go there with a book, with a Bible. I'm telling you, they will accept you. Even if you took their people as slaves, they will not kill you. They will accept you once you talk about the Bible. But if they fail, they want to kill you or to do one thing, because you're going to take two things. Take the Bible and the gun. First, present to them the Bible. We know to work. If they become rebellious, then they think. They become rebellious because they think, they imagine whatever was happening, and they become rebellious, then use the gun. Shoot them. Kill them all so that you can survive. So a white person, as they came to do the exploration, to do whatever, they came with two things, the Bible and the gun. And that history, which is written like that, is true. And that's what was done from where they were coming from. I've got the letters. I've got some letter, one letter, this ancient letter. I've got an ancient letter to that. So they came, and when they came, then they presented the Bible. What? Guess what? We accepted. And they couldn't even use the gun. Hallelujah.
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 And as we were singing and singing and singing and singing and clapping and dancing and what? Busy, our minerals were being taken by big vehicles and by trains. As we are singing and praying, hallelujah, with the Bible they have given us. Kai, that's a book. We are people of the book. And that's what we have been missing. We have been missing our God. And we did bad to our God. Now they have brought back a book to find our God. So we were behind the book and like that. And what happened? When we woke up, the whole of our countries were all ransacked. Everything taken away. And when we went to the other world, We find our people we sent there prior. Now they have got the materials to build those countries. And then they built and finished it up. And our people were still slaves. And we are still slaves here. What happened? Then they came back. They gave us their language. They came back. They gave us the rules of how to run the economy of the countries. They were started running the economy as per their way of understanding. In their books, there were keynotes in their books whereby you can note whatever you are going to do, you still pay homage to them. It still works for them. It's high time we removed that veil. We made up our own accounting books, economical books, our own way of how to do things. And also for the politicians, our politicians are also some of the people, I'm talking about politicians in Africa, some of the people that are also blinded. You know what they do? They steal the money. They are stealing money from their own. And we know where they send it. They send the banks, the foreign banks. That's where they send it. They're stealing. Now, when the money becomes so huge, so much accumulated there, the guys are checking the balances. Well, they say, this one has got a lot of money. Put up sanctions in this country. Put up this and this and that. Set up these cases against them. They set up the cases. Then the country writes to that country and says, freeze the accounts. Then they freeze the accounts. When they freeze the accounts, the money doesn't come back to the country. Then after some years, that money which was frozen is given to the central bank of that country. And from there, the money goes. Where is all the monies of Gaddafi? Before we talk about all that, that money was supposed to go come back into Libya. And then Libya would have been built properly. Where is all the money? Huh? It was frozen. Did you go back to that? No. Build up. So that's how, when you get your wealth, you send it back to your masters. Your masters are still clever. They'll still get you, they'll get you killed, and they'll get that. It's high time, brethren. It's high time we crossed over to the culture of God. We crossed over to the farming of God. It's high time we crossed over to the medicines of God. It's high time we crossed over to the worship of God. It's high time we crossed over to following God and following our Bible. Our Bible is the book of the Israelites, our book. It's not the book of the Gentiles. It is our book. Let us follow our book in every area and we'll manage. So I hope and believe that you have been blessed by these teachings. I have got so many other things that I need to talk about. This is just a few things, but I've got a lot of all these things to talk about. I've got all this to talk about. Hallelujah.
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 I hope you've been blessed. And if you're out there, please subscribe to the Great Awakening of the Bantu Israelites. And wherever you are in the world and you are Israelite, you are part of this. Let us come together. Stop criticizing each other. Stop fighting. Stop becoming near more Hebrew. This one is more less. This one is what and what? No. Even sometimes we talk about the white. But yeah, with the time coming up like that, some of the Hebrews can be white. You must understand that. But when you are talking about identification, we will use black because there were only black people. They were black that time. But if today Rapture marries, it's my firstborn. If Rapture marries a white lady, then he has a boy, a colored boy. Then this colored boy from a white lady and Rapture. This colored boy marries a lady from Canada, extremely white. They will have a colored boy. That boy, those boys are colored, but they are still having the gene of Cephas. Are you getting me?
Yes.
Of Mami.
Yes.
They're still having my gene. But their complexion is different.
Yes.
Because they're borrowing the body of the woman all the time, all the time, all the time. But inside them, It's the safest. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
So then that boy who is a grandson to rapture is almost like white. That other boy marries another white person. Mm-hmm. What happens? The other boy will just completely be white.
Yes.
But that completely white boy is still a mangi. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
He's still got my gene.
Yes, sir.
So, in other ways, we should stop ever trying to look at the colors in one way or another. But when we are identifying the authentic Israelites, we must go to the color. That's important. But when we are talking today, we must be more liberated in our thinking, so that we know what is happening, that generations have passed. So you can have even others would be white, others could be Indian, others could be different colors, others could be white, they could be different. So as we come together as Israelites, we are coming in different shades. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are coming in different shades. Mm-hmm. But the majority, I know they're going to be black because that's a default color. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So accept all those who come and they are your brothers. Mm-hmm. And as well for Christianity, embrace us. You are a spiritual Israelites. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are spiritual Israelites and the owners of God. When you attach yourself to us, you'll find God. When you bless us, you'll find God. When you walk with us, you'll find God. When you curse us, you are cursed. If you cannot find God now without us, you need to come to us. You need to come to us. Of course, yes, you can go directly to Jesus. Even Jesus is Hebrew. It's us. That's what I'm saying. You cannot bypass us. We are there for you. And we're not boasting. We have suffered enough not to boast anymore. The last phase, we are building and we are writing the last chapter. We are the people to take the whole world to the top of the mountain where they can meet the God of Jacob. I bless you. You are blessed. You are healed. You are delivered. You are Israel. You are blessed. You are spiritual. Bantu or Hantu means spiritual people. You are spiritual people. You are separated. You are separated. I'll be talking about Israel as I start, so that you can know Israel is an English word. But I will tell you where it came from and what it is and how we've been using the same word without knowing. God bless you and shalom. I love you.